Can you show people where to find their dampers?
It's kind of in between seasons, and so areas of the house that used to be cold are now too warm, and areas that were too warm are now too cold. So
exactly.
Let's adjust the damper.
Okay.
It's up here. What you're going to see on your ductwork is something that looks like this. And what we're looking at here is there's actually a damper inside this piece of duct here. And see this little flat spot right in the center of it? That is the position of the damper. So if you think of the damper like this, that's the position of the damper. So can you see how it is closed? And if I now want to open this damper, this is like a big wing nut on the outside edge. You just loosen it up like that, and now you can move this damper. So see, now I can move to the open position. See the flat spot here? Mm-hmm. The damper is now positioned like this. Can you see how that's now going to allow air to flow through the ductwork? And so once you get it to the position you want, this is now open. We now have airflow going through it, and we tighten the wing nut down, so now it is firm. You know, I can't move it right now. That's how you adjust it. Now, if there's times where it still seems stiff, go and look on the other side of the ductwork, because there is another handle just like this. I've loosened it up. It's on the other side of the duct. So, you know, think of it as got a wing nut on each end of the damper. So it may be that you need to loosen up another one on the other side for it to be free enough for you to be able to move it.
This looks not super convenient. So I was wondering if you could show everybody how your actual dampers work with the zoning system.
Right. So in this house, we have a zoning system, which means we have one furnace, one air conditioner here, but we have split it up into four comfort zones inside the house. So there's actually four thermostats throughout the house that will control a damper electrically. Okay.
So you don't personally have to come down and manually.
That's right. So we are constantly opening and closing dampers like this all throughout our system. Now let me show you. I'm going to come down off this ladder. Here's where we were up on the ladder. Come over here. There is a duct that comes up overhead, and you see that little saucer type device there? That is actually a pneumatic damper that is going to open and close the airflow in that particular duct. If you look down the opposite direction, all of our ducts have little dampers in there. Every single run have a damper. So those have been now wired to our zoning panel and will either open or close to maintain whatever temperature we preset. Now here is our zoning panel. This is called an Arzel zoning panel. These are pneumatic dampers. Those dampers aren't electric. They actually use air pressure to open and close. And this is the control center that you have down here, and it will tell us exactly what's going on. We can see here that it's 77 degrees outside air temperature. Our leaving air temperature right in that duct up where, right next to where we were up there, is actually a sensor in the duct. The temperature of the air is 73 degrees in the duct, and I can toggle through all of my different zones. And zone one is just calling for the fan to be on. Zone two is calling for the fan. All three, that's zone three and zone four, they're all calling for just the fan to be on. So we're not calling for heating or cooling. Let's experiment just a little bit, and I'll show you how we can change that. We're gonna adjust one of our thermostats down here. We're already in the heat mode, and you can see it's 73 degrees, but we have it set on 71. So let's raise it up to 74, and I just heard a little noise. And now if you look, the leaving air temperature is 73. Oh, but look, it's starting to climb already, 74. The outside temperature is 76 degrees. It's 75. If I toggle through, zone one says fan. Zone two is calling for the fan. Zone three, but zone four, which is my lower level walkout basement, it is actually calling for heat now. Okay, so we've got one of the four zones is calling for heat, and now look, my leaving air temperature is already up to 83 degrees. And that's because our heat pump has come on. I heard a little click go, and our heat pump is on, and it's now warming. It's up to 90 degrees now. It's that immediate from that zone panel. It turns on our heating and cooling equipment, and it will operate as needed now.
And it's only going into the zone down here, so it's not heating the upstairs.
That's right.
More sun.
Those other three zones are calling for just fresh air. They just want to circulate air. Mm-hmm. The only place the heat is coming out is in that lower level. I was talking to actually one of the technicians the other day, and he was actually talking about how his lower level is cold in the wintertime. And you've experienced this, but our lower level in the wintertime can actually be the warmest part of the whole house.
Because of the zoning.
The zoning, you know. So you can be downstairs in our rec room and where our big TV is, and you can watch a movie and actually be warm and comfortable. And I've always said that will never be your favorite room if you're not comfortable in it. But as you can see, look at the leaving air temperature. It's already up, it's up to 106 now. And the variable drive blower in the furnace here, you see, you can just barely hear that it's ramped up. So that's the next step up, manually adjusting. But yes, these dampers are opening and closing all the time.
So, cool.
Yeah.